Stand by. I want to get some more on all of this. Republican Senator James Lankford of Oklahoma is joining us. He's a member of the Homeland Security and Intelligence Committees. Senator, thanks very much for joining us. I want to get your immediate reaction to what we heard from Senator McCain, that the president originally, he said, is directly responsible, and then he later clarified. Do you agree with Senator McCain?
Yeah, he should have directly clarified that and say, obviously, the president's not directly responsible for that. The problem the president has with what McCain said is it's very similar to what Brennan said today in the CIA hearing that we had in an open hearing. When I asked him personally about the lone wolf attacks and what's happening in other regions, and asked him specifically about the caliphate in Syria and Iraq, how do we actually deal with this? Will we slow down these lone wolf attacks until we actually deal with that caliphate? Brennan's response back is, we have to deal with that caliphate. As long as that caliphate is there and they continue to motivate people, they're going to continue to motivate these lone wolf attacks around the world. And so while obviously the president's not personally responsible, and that's not the best way to be able to say that, as long as that caliphate is allowed to be able to stay there and we're not taking on them as an entity, they're going to continue to promulgate people, whether it's at a Christmas party in California last year, or whether it's in a nightclub in Orlando, they're going to continue to press and find lone wolf attacks.
Will you vote, Senator, in favor of the gun legislation that's coming up early next week? One that would prevent those on the terror watch list from getting a gun. The other would extend background checks for gun shows. How will you vote?
Yeah, I would tell you, I'm looking at all of those. The first principle for me is we have a Second Amendment and we need to have whatever we pass to be constitutional. So some of the challenges that are out there, they're trying to remove constitutional rights without actually going through due process. You can't do that. We couldn't say to one of these suspected terrorists, you can no longer talk on the phone, no longer talk on the internet, no longer go on to mosque, because those are protected constitutional rights. We can't say because you're a suspect, we take your phone away and can't go on the internet. You have to actually show something. You can't do that for the Second Amendment rights as well. And what I would want to reiterate to you is it's already the law right now. If someone is known or suspected as a terrorist, they cannot just walk in and buy a firearm. They have a long waiting period that actually kicks in, that the system itself will kick them out. The FBI is pinged on that, and they get some options to be able to deal with. So it is already current law. So there's a lot of pushback to say all these known terrorists can just walk in and buy a gun at a gun store. That is not correct. They are already held back and already cannot walk in and buy a gun at a gun store.